Well, Meat, we've done pretty good for ourselves. I mean, we did save the wasteland and all. Brought fresh water to the people or other noble crap like that. Whatever. I mean, sure, I didn't get the money for it. I didn't get the rights to sell the water. But on the plus side, we're now doubly famous for being both the author of the Wasteland Survival Guide and being the person that brought clean drinking water to the wasteland. So, there's that. And of course, we've built up Crater Side Supply with the help of, well, with Moira. I won't say with the help of, I kind of did all the thinking and most of the work. And, you know, we're getting on our way to being fabulously wealthy. But bigger and better things always meet. And to that end, I now need to seal the deal. I need to get married to Moira. And then, when I really build this place up, I'll be guaranteed to at least half of it, no matter what happens. But, you know, I figure as a budding businessman, Meat, I'm gonna need to have a different look. I can't be just walking around town in those dusty armor stuff that I was wearing around the wasteland. I need to look respectable. So, I liberated this knight's suit from that Eulogy Jones fella back in Paradise Falls. And I have to say, I think I'm looking pretty good. Pretty good indeed. So, yeah. This is how we're gonna strut about town. And, now I think it's time to make Moira mine, finally. Crazy woman. Yeah, whatever. Whee! Now, here are my two ladies.
How's the field research going? Yes! Okay. It sounds crazy when you say it that way.
Yeah, but you like crazy things.
Oh, hi. It's a
Here we go. We've become Megaton's first family. And proving that we can do anything together, I've decided to ask Moira to marry me. Well, you know, public commitment. I'm still entitled to half her stuff. Alright, let's do it.
Have you seen a radi flange around here anywhere? I could really use one.
I don't actually know what a radi flange is.
What can I get you? Oh, I never get to discuss semantics with anyone anymore. Sure thing. I'm an open book. What do you want to know? What? Really? Really? You really mean that? You and me. Together?
Well, you, me, and right. Your money. I mean, our money.
Yes, we all need something that keeps us going. For me, it's you. Love machine. You're a mighty lucky one, you know that.
Well, I am a love machine, I can't argue there. Okay, now we gotta find that stupid priest. And we'll kill him later at some point, though.
Yes?
Doesn't seem to be in his usual spot. Let's check inside his church. Oh, wait, it's over there. Oh, leave me alone, people. I'm not that good. You just don't know about all the things I've done in secret. Like genociding cat people. Alright, well. I don't see the idiot in here. Just a bunch of child of atoms. Or something. Let's check back outside. I hear him. Maybe he was just getting lunch or something. There he is in his more or less usual spot. No, I've been around for a while, you moron.
Humble little community, dear child, I am Confessor.
Yeah, I know who you are. Tell me about how you idiots get married.
Why, yes, we do. How much would you like to donate?
Why am I not surprised that you want money?
Even those who are not dedicated children of Adam may bask in his glow.
Oh, good.
Light shine on your path. You will find no wealth in the wasteland.
Yeah, yeah, whatever. It's a bargain if it gets me half of Crater Said.
Behold! He is coming with the clouds!
Hey, keep your coming to yourself, buddy. Let's see, what time is it? Too late today. Let's see, 14 hours ought to do it.
Yeah.
Alright, now head to the church. I need you to stop talking to me, idiot. How's that? How do you like them apples, biatch? Looks like everybody's already here. Except for, Moira, possibly. I guess I should probably bring her along. Hello. Let's go get her. I guess that's kind of important when you're getting married.
Come on, let's go.
You come too. I'm sure you want to see my wedding. Nice haircut, by the way, Sydney.
Good to see you.
Did you? It's time to get married. I'll get you to come with me. Oh, there we go. Alright. Come on. Come on, ladies. We've got a wedding ceremony to attend, or a fusion ceremony, I guess. Cause, you know, whatever.
Yeah, you need something?
No, I need you to shut up. Busy man, I'm getting married. Alright, here we go.
Hello.
Where do I stand? Here? We're standing there, maybe. Oh.
It is so good to see you again, dear child. Remember, the church.
Yeah, I guess everybody's ready.
Let those who dwell here in his favored land attend now to the words of the prophet of Adam. Let the men and women of Adam come forth into new life in the forge of your glow. Yea. Your suffering shall exist no longer. It shall be washed away in Adam's glow. Adam, come. Bestow your presence, my brother, my sister.
Hey.
Close your eyes.
Tell Adam to keep his hands to himself.
Moira, do you wish to stay true until the day of division?
I do.
My brother, do you wish to stay true until the day of division?
Yeah, sure.
Each single atomic mass contains within it an entire universe. Occasionally, a divine event occurs. We see creation and unification.
This is some weird, creepy metaphor for sex.
In atoms glow.
You're a creep.
Come forth and drink the waters of the glow.
Yo, dude, keep the waters of the glow to yourself.
Each shall know peace, shall be mother and father to a trillion civilizations, and shall know Adam in his glory.
Look, I don't want to know Adam, especially not in the biblical sense.
Walk in the glow. I wish you well on your path.
I got a wedding ring. Look, everybody's here. Fox and...
If you're gonna talk, talk!
Shut up, Fox. Moriarty, Dr. Lee, these other Project Purity idiots. Who's that? Nova, the hooker. Hey, Lucy. What's up, baby? One of these days, me and you. Fucking Sims is here. Fuck that guy. Still gonna kill him one day. Soon. Alright, Moir. Well, we're hitched. And I own all half your stuff. And everybody's leaving. Nice, quick, to the point ceremony. Alright, Moira.
You need something?
Huh. Did you know the human body can survive without the stomach or spleen?
Creepy and fascinating.
What's up?
So, it's time to expand. I'm gonna turn this money of yours into money of mine and more of it.
Ethan, I'm not sure I can believe that, and I'm downright gullible. Or, so I'm told.
They told you right.
A bit of smarts leads to a big reward, huh?
Yep, that's why I'm here.
We all need something that keeps us going, despite all the terrible things around us.
Yeah, like money. Alright, more profits for us. Alright, so we get to convince those creepy bisexuals in the fucking sewers to guard and help build. And that vaguely hot broad to help run the new store, huh? Alright, well, to work. Start with the creepy bisexuals. Dum dum dum. I guess I better run healed around here. You never know what's gonna come up. Just a nice, small, simple revolver. Nothing to scare anybody, get anybody nervous. You never know, when you might run into some feral ghouls or actual ghouls that I'd want to kill. You know, whatever. I am looking fly, though. Vance, you creepy motherfucker.
Come back to the scary vampire lair, have we?
Not so much scary.
Always a pleasure to receive you in Moresti. What brings you down here today? What do you propose? You wish to arrive at some sort of a bargain?
Yes, but nothing creepy or bisexual, so please stop talking that way. Jesus.
I thank you for showing me that your kind can be trusted. What little money Carl makes with his shop goes to buying weapons and ammunition.
And Bavarian sex toys.
Your words echo the very reason this place was established.
No. Wait, I didn't say anything about bisexual orgies.
Agreed. Please, take this proposal to Arafood.
Will do. I can't get out of here quick enough. If you guys had a quicker way in and out. I guess I don't have to come down here too often though, thankfully.
Needed a place to get out of the sun for a while.
Yeah, whatever, creep. No, don't hurt me with your pitching machine. That saved your town, you should have a little more enthusiasm.
I'm glad I was wrong about you. Welcome back.
You look less vaguely hot than I remember.
What's up? Do you? Well, I guess so.
Look vaguely hot, chick. I want more enthusiasm out of you.
Great, that's good news. I appreciate it.
Better. You're still at about a 6, though. I need you at an 11. Oh, well, that just kind of appeared out of nowhere, didn't it? Cool. It's like magic. What was this? Yeah, that's their house. This is the store. And this is a apparently random guy from the family who looks like a cheap version of Vance.
Hey there.
Hey there. Get a Chinese officer's sword and a scoped magnum, a railway rifle. This is an interesting little selection of goods you got here. Whatever. More profits for us. Solomon likes profits. Jesus, why is everything so blown out? Well, we'll take that. Seems to be unique. Alright. Now let's talk to Karen. Now that she's apparently the shopkeeper, even though she's not standing over there. Maybe we have to, like, leave and come back.
Welcome. Well, sure.
What do you got? Anything good? You got no caps. That's unfortunate. And no, you don't really have anything good, but that'll probably change over time. Anyways. Next. Where are you, Mortar? There you are.
Have you seen a Rady Flange around here anywhere?
I told you, I don't even know what one is.
Really use one. Never mind. What can I get you?
Yeah, now it's time to open up a store in Canterbury Commons, baby.
Really? Tell me all about it. Well, okay, I guess. I can take care of all that with the traders I know.
Yes! This is gold material I'm giving you.
Yeah, traders bring in lots of particularly nifty junk.
Yeah, this obsession with junk is well known.
A lot to me, you know.
Of many varieties.
Let me think.
Why don't you leave the heavy thinking to me?
I'll take care of that for you.
Well, let's see, a mostly intact building in the commons. And a creepy friend named Krieger. He's apparently super capable.
Hi.
Alright, well, off to Canterbury Commons. The hell are you?
Yes?
Oh yeah, you're that guy. This appears to be the place. Alright. Fair enough. The hell is this idiot? Oh, there he is.
What can old Uncle Ro do for you today?
Don't call yourself old Uncle Ro. It just makes you sound like a fucking pedo. That mustache ain't helping.
Quite organized now. They make more profits and supplies to get to those that need the most. They still travel independently, but I keep track of their investments and such.
Look, I'm gonna be in charge around here, alright? Not you.
The economics of this sort of trading operation can be rather more complex than your standard store and settlement, sadly.
Yeah, well, just because you have a shit understanding of economics doesn't mean I do.
My, my. When it comes to sales, I can see even I've got a few things I could learn from you.
I'm the smartest fucking guy in the wasteland.
I think you're right. It could work.
Of course it'll work.
I agree wholeheartedly. Such is the magic of economics.
It's not magic, you fucking idiot. No wonder you're fucking incompetent. Alright, where's this machete person? Right there, apparently. Patrolling the rubble.
What
good job.
Can't you see I'm busy?
Yikes. I want you to be less of a bitch. How's that?
Fine. Hi. Whatever. I'm Machete, and I've got better things to do.
I said less of a bitch.
Good guess. I was the toughest defender they ever saw in Lamplight. I earned my nickname fighting off a mole rat with a knife as big as my arm.
Ooh,
when I left, I figured I'd pass on a cushy place like Big Town. I ended up here. Dom took me on as a guard. And that's that.
Yeah, it just further goes to show he's a sucker, but I guess you're the best we got.
Yeah, maybe. What do you want? What? Can't you see I'm busy? Can't let our guard down.
Busy guarding a shitty strip with one store.
Okay, fine.
Well, that was annoying.
Hi there.
Shut up, kid. Alright, well, lucky our new store. There's a giant bobblehead in the window. It's a pretty awesome store. New Nuka-Cola and Nuka-Cola Classic. Yeah, clearly Nuka-Cola Classic's better, though it has more rads. Huh. Well. This is, interesting. Certainly get a lot of shit for sale. Weapons and everything. You must be this Grieger creep. You seem to be stuck. And you have a Pip-Boy. That's interesting.
How's it going, dude? Pleased to finally meet you. Where's told me a lot about you. My name's Grieger. We used to hang out back when she lived here. We tinker around with the old robots or try to make ant repellent or whatnot. Good times.
Yeah, I can see why you liked each other.
Well, I used to run a caravan all the way to Chicago. That's gotta count for something.
What's a Chicago?
I also helped Maura set up her first trade route at Craterside, so I know how she works. Well, there's usually a Hummer waiting for us in a Columbus flat, so that's like half the trip right there. But when the Brotherhood's stretched thin, we need Deathclaw escorts. They're worth every cap, but they don't have the best social skills. Long story.
Weirdo.
Well, now you got all the traitors on board, this could actually work out pretty well.
No shit, it'll work out well. I'm running it.
Things we can do to expand our selection, but maybe get some really choice items for the traitors. Anyway, thanks for the job. It's place could really turn out quite well indeed, and I'm happy to be a part of it. Good to be working with Moira again, too.
Hey, hands off my lady.
Hola, amigo.
Don't you speak your commie gobbledygook at me. This is fucking America. I speak a good American here.
Now that you have all the caravans working together with the commons as their hub, I think we can explore some profitable side projects. I suppose we could extend our supply lines a bit. Maybe pay the traders to go a little deeper and connect with those city prospectors.
Yeah, do it. If it's dangerous, fuck them.
How's it going, dude?
Stop calling me dude.
Now that you have all the caravans working together with the commons as their hub, I think we...
You already said that.
Got wind of a merc squad eager to take out some raiders. If we finance the mission, we could get a decent supply of gear out of it. Also, less raiders.
Good plan. Glad I thought of it.
Ni hao, comrade.
Now you're really speaking commie gobbledygook at me.
Now that you have all the caravans working together with the commons as their hub, I think we can explore...
Yeah.
Well, I suppose we could hire salvagers to pick over the Enclave's battleground. Dangerous. Expensive. Very, very profitable.
Yeah, I've been doing it myself for a while. They were my battlegrounds, of course, but, you know, whatever.
How's it going, dude? Now that you have all the... I know a guy. Deals in unique items. I don't ask questions.
Are we talking weapons or sex toys?
Pricey, though.
Alright, well then. Groovy.
Bonjour, mon ami.
I told you to stop speaking that damn commie speak.
I can't think of anything unless those rumors about a spaceship are true. In that case, we should totally open a shop on the moon.
Are you high?
Ni hao, comrade. Actually, there is one thing. Take a look.
Yeah, what do we got?
Yep, supposedly the thing's more accurate at night. I'm not sure how that's possible. Still, damn fine gun.
Sweet. Alright, well, let's see what else we got going on in this place. Oh, caps, don't mind if I do. Sure, some skill books. Huh? Items to be sold. I wonder if I'm supposed to put things in here to add to the stock. Let's try it, I've got a bunch of useless crap. Yeah. Here, sell some of that for me, Grieger. Look at that, you got comic book patches on your back. Stop moving like a retard so I can look at your back. Grognak the Barbarian. And Captain Cosmo or something. Something like that. You're a nerd. Alright, what do we got in the employee area? A refrigerator filled with delicious deviled eggs. Cold machine, of course. Some promotional mini fridges that are filled with a lot of stuff, strangely enough, despite being very small. Tech nerd glasses. Huh. Alright. What was that? Interesting. looks like a normal vault suit to me. Let's see about those tech nerd glasses. Lots of stuff. They look more or less like regular glasses.
Yeah,
whatever. Put my lucky shades back on. Alright. We get a lot of weird stuff in here. Meat, you gotta stop panting so much. We gotta get you more exercise or something. Look at that, my giant bobblehead. Wait, door to large vertical area? That's the same area. Whatever. Alright, well, that was interesting. But, again, more profits for me. Let's see about this pistol. I like a scoped pistol. Shut up, dumb kid. Uh-huh, sure is. Alright, let's go back to Megaton.
Hey!
Hey! Get a little bit of rest. Nice long rest. Solomon's tired. Maybe not that long. That's good. Alright, let's head back out there. Out of the way, mate. See if he sold any of that stuff for me. What are you doing in here?
You made this place get so boring.
Yeah, I'm awesome. I made it get profitable. Alright, let's see here. There was no money in the register, so I'm guessing you didn't sell anything. He's bad. Oh well.
How's it going, dude? Actually, there is one thing. Take a look. Thing belonged to a red Chinese sleeper agent, legend goes. Supposed to wipe out his whole neighborhood when the war started.
So there's a commie
now,
like you.
And what was very likely bullshit pre-war propaganda, but this thing could definitely do the job. When you absolutely positively got to kill every damn raider in the room, they accept no substitute.
If you say so, buddy.
How's it going, dude?
Right, get it in the fucking store so I can buy from you. You jackass. It's 11 a.m. God damn it. What kind of fucking shit show are you running around here? What is this? A flophouse for the caravans? Are we paying for that?
Ni hao, comrade. You've got an amazing selection thanks to you. Browse away.
Yeah, I'm pretty awesome. Lots of ammo. That's for sure. A lot of weird stuff. Decent amount of caps too. Yeah, alright. I'll let you live for now. He also just gave me a tip on a new place to check out. A place that might be good for a scavenger room. This place, the Dunwich Building. Sounds perfectly harmless. Apparently, the local raiders and whatnot won't touch it because they have ghost stories about it being haunted by zombies or some such bullshit. But, you know, Solomon doesn't believe in such things. There's probably some ghouls in there, and, you know, what's a few ghouls? Now, we are going to get back into some battle gear for this. Guess I'll put my wedding ring on. We're going to try out some battle armor. Even though it's not usually my style, I will put my old bandana on. There we are. Me and Sid match, isn't that cute? Alright. This way. Ooh, a Deathclaw. Guess we can try out this new scoped pistol. Thing's got quite a kick, that's for sure. I do like having a scope on a pistol. Where that Deathclaw got off to, though. That's probably him there. Nope! Take a beating. Still don't know where that Deathclaw got off to. Maybe that scorpion killed him. This must be the building here. Fuck you. The fuck is that? I don't know what that is. Seems to be a weird physics-y thing that shouldn't be happening. It's a giant rat scorpion. Oh, whatever. In any case, let's head inside the building. Sure, I'll take your bullets. Not so much your grenades. I definitely hear ghouls. Audio logs. See what this is all about.
Why the hell would he come all the way out here? Dad's been a little nuts for some time now, but not like this. Leaving me in that crappy old hospital without waking me. Without a goddamn flashlight. I made enough selling the meds we scrounged to have kept us both fed at the colony for weeks. Now I'm almost out of rations, my shoes are pretty much destroyed, and I'm still chasing the old poop. By my last reckoning, he was headed south.
Fuck the old coot. You are a punk. I have killed you. Hey, meat, instead of growling, how about you kill something?
Anybody there? Had enough?
Good job, ladies. And meat. Next audio log.
Maybe I shouldn't have waited so damn long to start tracking. The trail's going cold.
You sound like a stupid fuck.
They wander with these guys. They say they wander the area.
Oh no!
Good thing, Meat's such a capable tank. Settle yourself, Three Dog. Looks like another one.
Time once again for an important GNR.
Shut up. Next audio log.
These guys aren't who I thought they were. Jesus, they killed a family for a sack of rotten vegetables.
If you're gonna kill a family, do it for something good. That's what I always say.
Hit a caravan today. Trev didn't see the kid and got popped. Took care of Tawny right then. I put one in Thor before he saw her fall. That earned me some grub from the traders. Even better, they saw Dad. He was in pretty rough shape. Still has the goddamn book. The trader says it gave him the creeps. Me too. But it's good to know he's still alive. Still headed south. He must have been trying to trap food here. I recognize his snares. I can make out a building on the horizon. That must be where he headed. If not, at least I get a roof tonight.
Yeah, I don't know if this is the kind of place I'd want to sleep. I'm not saying, I'm just saying. Who just opened that door?
Leave me alone! Yeah. I'm glad that's over.
Yeah, fucker.
I don't like the look of this place.
Yeah.
I don't like the smell.
Yeah. Ghouls are smelly.
Risk a shot at the crows till I know what's in there.
Crows.
Oh no!
Lock and load.
Damn it.
Nice shooting, Moira. Your goofy railway gun.
Said, but close.
Where the hell do you come from that you've never seen ghouls?
I think they really used to be people.
Yeah, dumbass. You're a dumb fucker, aren't you? That was weird. Never seen something quite like that before. At least not in this world. Back in Cyrodiil, I'd expect something like that. This place is supposed to make more sense.
Over here.
Over where? Where are these jackbags?
Keep them pinned.
I keep them real pinned. Oops. I don't even know where you people have gotten off to. Over here, I guess. Your physics seem to be malfunctioning as well. Yeah, here we go.
I know. I found Dad today. I didn't think it was him. Face. The zombies didn't touch him. I think he was becoming like that. Didn't know
cool.
him until I found that old book near him.
Man, no more killing. Not really.
I just need to go. Can't forget the book. All I have left of him is warm.
Sounds like that guy's going crazy or something. Then again, I did have a vision a little while ago, so there's that. I guess I shouldn't necessarily be questioning other people's sanity. Yay, I win. Wait a minute, that's after the Great War. Fun. Well, anyways. Yeah, what's in here? If it's locked, there's probably something good back there. Yay, I win. More goofy poltergeists or something. Look, you're not scaring me, you're just pissing me off. This computer appears to be haunted. Cool. moving along. No, don't knock me off. Ah, there we go. I won you. Look at you, being all stupid. Alright, where the hell am I supposed to go? This way? Maybe? Yeah, this must be the way. You're dead. You are dead. What's that like? Oh, hello, friend. Say goodbye to your head. This shithead. Come here, jackbag. Ooh, two for one. Sort of. Not exactly. Let's make a jump for it. God damn it. Our nerves. Well, I guess this is the way I was supposed to go.
Side of your own blood.
Sharp knife to send him to Deep Temple. Play and say my words. Abdul comes again on the feast of the weaker, feast for the Deep Temple. Born again, here, Alhazared.
Yep, definitely went crazy. Alright, where are you, fuckers? Pick you off from above. My scoped pistol. There you are. Toast. Ooh, shot your leg out from under you. How's that? And Moira took good care of you. So like getting beat up by a girl, huh, ghoul? Are you punching him, Moira? What's wrong with your gun?
Hey, you!
Are you out of bullets, apparently? I didn't know you actually required any for that. Let's see. What do you got for weapons? Yeah, you can take my, that stuff for now. What's the hunting rifle use? 32s, yeah, you can take those too. There you go, lady. Make it creepy. Yeah. There's the crazy man himself. I listened to all your best hits. Oh. Well. There's a creepy altar. Hmm. Well, isn't that nice? Well. This wasn't a very good tip, Grieger. I didn't find anything good in here. Just a crazy fucking regular ghoul and a bunch of feral ghouls. And a creepy fucking altar that's gonna give me nightmares. Also, I had a creepy vision. So you better have something good for me when I get back, Grieger. Good, it's dark out. To the commons. Got me all nervous there, more uncocking your shit and whatnot. This is a caravan or flop. They come right by my store. Look at that.
Morning.
Hi, Crow. T-Robot.
Welcome, welcome. My name is Crow, and I travel the... If the clothes make the man, then here are the means to remake yourself.
Same old crappy stuff's normal. Where the hell are you, lazy fuck? There you are.
Hola, amigo. Actually, there is a take a look. It's the legendary Brotherhood Sniper's gun. Supposedly the gun hates mutants. It'll do way more damage against super mutants and feral ghouls.
So it's magic is what you're telling me. I don't like magic. When the hell are you gonna sell some shit, huh? Now I'm gonna sleep here till tomorrow.
Actually, there is one thing. Take a look. This thing is insane, man. It was a priceless antique well before the bombs dropped. I think it was a dueling rifle. Powerful. Fragile.
Rifles aren't really my thing, but antiques, on the other hand. Still haven't sold anything, you goddamn loser.
Hola, amigo.
you don't start selling, man, I'm gonna have to find another person to run this shop. Uncle Ro might do. He's a moron. So what does that say about you, Grieger?
How's it going, dude? Bonjour, Mona. Actually, now this one's a personal favorite. On the surface, no more than a fancy railroad shooter. But if you shoot a Robco robot with it, it fries their logic circuits, overloads their combat routines and motivation processors. Basically, it's a one-hit kill most times. Otherwise, it nukes their endurance and perception. You'll mop them up real quick after that.
Oh, I do hate robots, so that's useful. What is that goddamn noise in the background?
Ni hao, comrade.
Commie fucker.
You two have helped.
God damn it, where are you going?
You ever see a Yao Guai?
I've seen Yao Guai. Quiet.
What's up? Actually. Okay, now this one I almost don't want to talk about, man. This isn't from our normal guy. This dude was. Creepy.
Like you.
Guy with this freaky purple-yellow robe comes in, right? He says he has something special for you. He puts this case on the
desk. Yeah, superhero?
I ask, what's in it? He tells me it's a special gun from a special friend of ours. Give this to your associate with our blessing. Then he just turns and leaves. I mean, I went after him, but the dude was just gone. Now, I've seen some crazy shit in my day, but this? Creepy, man.
Sounds like fun. Briefcase full of foreboding. The Hound. And unusual bullets. And a tape. No. Sounds, interesting. Well, it certainly makes a weird noise when I draw it. Certainly oddly colored.
Going, dude.
Alright, did you sell anything yet? Jesus Christ, you suck. You're bad at life. Come on, some of that stuff's nice. one more day. I'm giving you one more goddamn day.
Actually, there is. Well, I got this toy car. Supposedly makes you faster if you carry it. It's magic. Look, I know it's crazy, but the kid who sold it to me was either a brilliant con man in training or totally serious. Maybe both. Thing couldn't hurt, right? Here, take it. I prefer to travel by pirate vertebrate these days, anyway.
Wait, can you hook me up with this pirate vertebrate business? Yeah, I'm not really a fan of magic, but I do feel a little faster. Not a lot. Just a little bit. I have this creepy red and black gun. It makes the same noise as opening a gore bag when I open it. Moira, why are you stuck in a wall? Come on, Moira. There you go, girl. Alright. Well. Let's head back to Megaton. Can't be seen walking around like this, though. Man, of certain influence around here. So put on a more respectable looking gun. There we go. Put it away, of course. Alright, ladies, well, I think we got off to a good start expanding Craterside. We've certainly increased our profits at least triple. And we stand to make quite a bit of money. So I think we've done a good bit for today. Let's retire back to HQ to rest up a little bit. And next week, or next episode, I will tell you all about my plans for a new business venture. But I'm going to keep that secret for now. Alright, this is Great Pirate Solomon signing off of episode 13 of The Misadventures of Great Pirate Solomon in the Capital Wastelands. I will see you guys later.